delighted to welcome you to the Institute of Fundraising Convention for 2017. It's great to see so many familiar faces here today, and also many new people here today. This year's convention promises to be our best ever. And if this is your first time, I know you're going to have an amazing few days. This is not just the most attended fundraising convention in Europe, but by far the most comprehensive and thought-leading in the world. It promises fantastic learning, as well as the very best network opportunities. So please enjoy every minute and get every outlet it has to offer. So today is somewhat bittersweet for me, as it represents my very last day as the chair of the Institute. And it's been quite a stint. My predecessor, Mark Castorita, I'm sure is in the room somewhere, had told me that the role was a piece of cake. And at the beginning of my time as chair, I certainly wasn't expecting the roller coaster ride of scrutiny and political turbulence that we've all gone through. But two general elections and an EU referendum later, I've managed to serve a whole 4 months longer than our previous Minister of Civil Society. Make of that what you will. But as I reflect on my time, at the end of my tenure, I can say that I'm in an optimistic mood. There are probably two ways of looking at my time as chair. Firstly, the story about what we call the summer of discontent of 2015, the ongoing media and political scrutiny of what we do day in and day out, but how we respond to that climate. But secondly, the story less told of the amazing things we have achieved over that period. The continuing growth in income across our sector, the renewed commitment to innovation and excellence, and the response to crises both here and abroad. And within both of these perspectives, one thing remains a constant for me. I'm as proud today of the Institute and our fundraising community as I was the day I became chair. But taking that summer of 2015 and its aftermath first, the headlines about some of those things, but our response as a sector, I think, is worth restating. The IOF responded quickly, fast-tracking the necessary updates to the code of practice, supporting the establishment of the new fundraising regulator, stepping up to respond in the media, working tirelessly behind the scenes to ensure that the FPS wasn't the big red button disaster that we all feared it might be, and perhaps more recently, supporting members and using our influence to encourage the ICO to take a proportionate approach in relation to the fines they were issuing. And while the IOF is stepping up, so are you, the wider community around us. You were reviewing and strengthening your fundraising practices to ensure you met the ever-changing expectations of our supporters and the public at large. So, I'm sure, whilst no one in the community would describe 2015 as a highlight, for the record, I would like to emphasise